वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्तम बिंदावन मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश कृपा सिंधु व्यवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्किपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं बिंदावी तुलसीदेव बिया पिया वी केशव सच स्नभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरीय पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नम् अविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्यहम् पुनतोपाल भवद्विभूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनि छटाय विस्फुरजितकमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे हरे आजान लंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकपितरौ कमलायताक्ष विशांबरु द्विजवरु जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणापतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगा तरंग रमणीय जटा कलापं गौरी निरंतर विभूषित वाम भागम नारायणो प्रियमनंगो मदापहारम वाराणसी गुरुपति भजवीशनाथम वागीश जुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसी यस्यास्ति हृदय संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Kayena vacha manasa indriyairva buddhātmanā vā anusṛto svabhāva karoti yad yad sakalam parasmai nārāyaneti samarpayetat kayena vacha manasa indriyairva buddhātmanā vā anusṛto svabhāva karoti yad yad sakalam parasmai narayaneti samarpayetat. Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, we will have to get rid of different kind of attraction and repulsion properties existing in this material world. Gauriya Goshtipati Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, anyhow we will have to get rid of this kind of material attraction and repulsion dharma which is existing in this nature. Material soul anyhow cannot cut this material bondage. Impossible. Repeatedly I am speaking to remind. Material soul anyhow cannot cut material bondage. Sadhu Guru Kipa Vina na dekhi upai. Maya re koriya jai charano na jai. Sadhu Guru Kipa Vina na dekhi upai. There is no way out except the Kipa of Guru Vaishnava. There is no way out except the Kipa of Guru Vaishnava. Only we will have to depend upon them. Brahmanda Brahmite Kono Bhagavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasade Pai Bhakti Latha Beach. You'll have to remember this point. You can remember Nimi Maharaj also asking in 11th canto in front of Nava Yogendra, Kovir, Hovir, Antariksha, Prabuddha, Piplayan, so many. They are there. Jadrichaya Gataha. Jadrichaya mane, not forcefully. Somehow, why? We cannot say. Mahat Bichalanam Nilam Dihina Gihinam Dina Chetasam. Why they are coming? Nobody can trace out the reason. So, it is written there, Navajanandru not coming out of any force or somebody going to give them inspiration, go there, not that. Jadricha, automatically they are coming. Who calling Shukdev Goswami? Eh? Who is going to make a telephonic call to Shukdev Goswami so that he is coming here via Hastinapur? He is straightway coming to this the spot where Parikshit Maharaj is sitting, Poyapavesham, Shuktal Khetra, at the bank of Ganga. Why Sukhdev Goswami coming? Nobody, Jadri Chayagata. There also it is a thing. Maybe by the inspiration of Supreme Lord, we cannot, externally we cannot find out any reason. We cannot find out any reason, external reason is not there. We cannot find why they are coming. So here actually, Srila Nimi Maharaj, you know, paying Dandabhat Pranam, glorifying them, going to worship them. Oh, I am very lucky today. How you are coming? Vaikuntha Priyadarshanam. It's impossible. You know, Vaikuntha means Hari, Tat Priya, he is dear and near ones, your Sadhu Guru Vaishnava. You are coming in front of me, what luck there, with me, I don't know. They are actually, after worshipping, Parikshit, actually Nimi Maharaj going to put some questions, so many questions there. I am not going to start from the beginning anyway, in middle, one question, Kovir Hovir. Asked Kovi, Havi. So he is putting question, Nimi Maharaj going to put question. Maharaj. Je Parasya Vishnu Ishasya Mahinam Upi Mahinam. Mahinam. Mahinim. Mayam Veditu Michamu Bhagavanto Bhruvantuna. Parasya Vishnu Rishasya Mayinam Upi Mohinim Mayam Veditum Ichhamu Bhagavantum Brumantuna. Please kindly, we like to know detailed information about what is Maya. We cannot understand Vishnu or Maya. Parasya, para asya Vishnu, Vishnu Rishasya. Big problem. Parasya Vishnur Ishasya Mayinam Upi Mohinim. Even those who are big, you know, authority, like Sankar, Indra, Brahma, they become hypnotized. Big Maya, actually. So, we like to know about Maya. What is Maya? What is Maya? That is the main question. Everybody is speaking Maya, Maya, Maya. Maya, toh, everybody is speaking Maya. But what is the scientific definition of Maya? That we like to know. If enough Guru Kipa is there with me, then I can easily realize when Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to give scientific definition. Vishnu Maya. Maya, two type of Maya, one is Antaranga Maya, one is Bahiranga Maya. Yogamaya and Mahamaya. So they have their respective function, duties, they are playing their duty. Here Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Supreme Lord, he is eternally existing internal Maya. Eternally existing Maya is actual Maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking definition. Somebody, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give explanation, explain scientific definition of Maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhagavan's Supreme Lord, His eternal potency, Antaranga Shakti is Maya, is actual Shakti. Bhagavan, His eternally present Shakti or internal potency is actually is real, but actually genuine Shakti. And except that, we can feel that as if some other Shakti is there. Bhagavan is actual Shakti that is internal potency, but except that another Shakti we feel as if there. Bhagavaner Antaranga Shakti Shakti. E Antaranga Shakti Baire Je Shakti Ache Bole Mone Hoy. Athocho Je Shakti Na Thakle Pore E Shaktir Kono Astitto Thake Na. In Bengali, as it is, I am speaking. I memorize it, I am speaking. Sometimes forgetting, but this I memorize. Bhagavan is internal potency, is Yogamaya, is the original Shakti, except that we feel that another Shakti is there, working. And at the same time, without that original Shakti, this Shakti can lose his her existence. Without the existence of that original Shakti, this Shakti cannot show his existence, her existence, lose existence. This is called, what do you mean by that? Actually, when you will have to understand this point, why Bhakti is very nice Bengali, very easy Bengali. Still, those who are making double time MA in Bengali, still they cannot answer. If they are not enjoying the Kipa of Guru Vaishnava, they cannot understand. Literally, actually, what is written, it is, they feel that we, they think that we understand, but not, inner meaning they cannot feel. Actually, point is that, whenever you are going to stand in front of a light source like sun god or moon god or any light source, then you can find one shadow beside you. That shadow. And that shadow you cannot see when the original light source is taken away from you. Then you cannot find that shadow anymore. So the original cause of that shadow coming due to that light source in front of you. To try to understand, digest this, you know, and feel this point. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving the exact example. Yogamaya is there. Yogamaya always trying to help us to get in connection with Supreme Lord. But Mahamaya going to put some repulsion. We feel repulsion. Because it is a duty given by Supreme Lord. You will have to discharge this duty. So, Yogamaya is, if Yogamaya is there, then there is shadow we can find in this material world. Srishti Sriti Paloya Sadhana Saktireva Saktireka Chayeva Jasa Bhavanani Vivarti Durga Ichchana Rupam Api Chestatesa Gavindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. You know. Sisti Siti Palaya Sadhana Sakti Rega Chayeva Jasya Bhuvanani Vibharti Durga. Durga maintaining one fort. Durga mean Durgo. Durga mean Sanskrit word, Bengali word. Durgo fort. Inside which she is bound to keep all Jivatmaya like corona patient. They cannot go outside. Under supervision. They cannot go outside. Treatment going on. Maya Devi giving different kind of treatment, punishment, everything. Anyhow, if they can feel detachment, it's okay. But actually, by the help of Guru Vaishnava, we can get this kind of chance. So, Maya Devi, Maya Devi going to put them inside one fort. Durga going to give treatment, good or bad, according to their past activities. You know, they are going to do. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, writing one kirtan in which Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to give an indication how we can respect this Maya, Yogamaya. Because anyway, we cannot see Mahamaya if we are at all going to get the Kripa of Guru Vaishnava. So, no question. How we can see Mahamaya? If you are Vaishnava, how you can see Mahamaya? You can see only Yogamaya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Kirtan very nicely. Kulodevi Yogamaya More Kipakori Avaron Sangbirube Tumi Vishwadori Sunechi Agam Vede Mahima Tomar Sri Krishna Bhimuke Dori Karao Sansar Sri Krishna Sanmukhojar Bhagyakome Hoy Tare Mukti Diya Karo Ashoka Avay Niskapata Hoye Mata Amapane Chao. It's very nice, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Kulodevi Yogamaya More Kipakori. Kulodevi means, in traditional heretical factor, you know, you are the Kulodevi Yogamaya. You are worshipped. And now, More Kipakori, at present you will have to show Kipa on me, right? proper kipa, exact kipa. And you will have to, you know, take out the bondage, I mean the covering. You will have to unveil the covering, screen. You will have to unveil the screen. Kulodevi jo mori ki bakori, avaron, avaron means covering. Avaron sangbaribe mane not sangbaribe. Sangbaran mane ma, for me you will have to take away your covering. Please don't, you know, avaron sangbi tumi bishodori, because the whole brahmanda is there inside your womb. Inside your womb, you know, tu bhi shodari. Sunichi agambhida mahimatama. I have heard about your glories in agam, nigam, agam vede, agam, nigam, everything there, agam vede, mahimatama, Sri Krishna bhimikodari karao sanshar. I heard that those who are averse to your seva, supreme, those who are averse to Supreme Lord, I mean Krishna, Vishnu, you are going to put them into jail. I heard. Sunecha agambhide mahimatuma, Sri Krishna bhimukhe dhari karao sansha, and Sri Krishna sanmukho, very, if their good luck, if their luck is favorable, then they can face Krishna. Sanmukho jar bhagya me hai, tare mukti diya karo ava. Then you are going to help them to cut bondage, everything. You, then in that case, you are going to help them to get in connection with Supreme Lord, so that they can enjoy doing seva, give full pleasure to Supreme Lord. This is the procedure. And niskapatemane, without any duplicity, ma, you please, in a causeless mercy, you must show me, to me. You know. And the whole world is in confusion, in maya. If they are hearing Harikatha from heart, then I can put guarantee by the, in the name of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they can cut maya. But I have some doubt. How much sincerity they have to hear this kind of Harikatha, I don't know. So yesterday I was speaking, na tarko apatishto sutayo vivinna. Yesterday I was, you know, omitting one word, but I now sometime actually forget. Vedo vivinna sritayo vivinna, I told. But actually it is very nice, but one word is that fast, that tarko apratishto sritayo vivinna. Tarko, logical interpretation, cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. It is the first point. Many times I told Prabhupada speaking, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. You will have to cut and throw it. Gyane prayasa mudopasa, I can discuss after. We are coming to this. So, we will have to throw away all logical interpretation. This kind of procedure is not allowed here. And srutayu vivinna, sruti, sruti, all different, you know, agam, nigam mean. Agam mean actually from Brahma, from Bhagavan, Krishna ite chaturmukh, hai Krishna sevanmukh, Brahma ite narodhidam, narodhidamudhi, narodho haite vyas, madhukaya vyas, this way. It's called nigam. So in Bhagavatam, nigama kalpa taror galitam phalam sukham khad amritadava sangyutam. This is written. So nigam mean, which is coming via the lotus mouth of Brahma. Another source from Sankarsan to Chatusan, Sankar Bhagavan, Chatusan, this way coming, you know, it is called agam. Sankar Bhagavan, also we can get Sankarsan, real original source is Sankarsan, this way. So agam, nigam, and Shruti mean Veda, and Shruti mean from Shruti, some vital parts are collected in the form of, you know, advice. It's called Shruti. Like Hari Bhakti Vilas, Vaishnava Shruti. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already, you know, giving and already Mahaprabhu was bound to give instruction, direct instruction to her, to Sanatana Gosai to compile by Snopsriti, because other Sriti, Sriti there, but it's confusing. Manusriti, these, that, so many there. But actually, Hari Bhakti Vilas is Vaishnava Sriti, all collection from different place, so that there is no confusion, so that there can be no confusion. Vaishnava Sriti, Hari Bhakti Vilas. Originally, it was compiled by Gopal Bhatta Goswami. It was, you know, it was again in edited and represented in right way by Sanatana Goswami ji. So, Suti Sriti, it is called Sriti. So, Suti Sriti actually, so all, we will have to always follow Suti and Sriti. Shruti and Siddhi will have to follow. There is different kind of arguments we are hearing. Mahaprabhu asking and Raya Ramananda going to answer. So here, first of all, we will have to know that Vaishnava Shruti Hari Bhakti Vilas is very, very accurate, appropriate. You can follow it. Because without following Hari Bhakti Vilas in each and every moment, every faction of the, you can make mistake. Because it is written warning there, Suti Siti Purana Adi Pancharatting Bidhing Bina. Pancharatri, Mahaprabhu already declared, what is this Suti Veda in Sruti, Sruti, it's exact thing in Pancharatri Vidhan. Pancharatri, different kind of Pancharatri Vidhan there. Narad Pancharatri, we consider Narad Pancharatri here. Naraji Maharaj going to speak, Rat, Pancharat, mane Pancham in five, Ratman again. Different, five different kind of knowledge compiled in such a way so that it can be helpful for bonded soul. So, Suti Siti Puranadi Pancharatik Bidhang Bina Vaikantiki Harir Bhakti Utpataibaka. It is one kind of hazard, big problem, Utpat, danger, excesses, Utpat. Without following Suti Siddhi Puranadi appropriately, inner meaning you will have to follow, then it is okay. Otherwise, the kind of bhakti now you want to show, it is one kind of excesses. It should be thrown away. Otherwise, and Pancharatik means Pancharatik is very good. Suti Siddhi Puran Pancharatra going to give us extract of pure devotional procedure. So now the sloka yesterday I wanted to say that logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of absolute, in the way of that absolute truth. So tarko apatishto srutayo vivinna. Tarko, logic cannot stand. At the same time, srutayo, ved, adi, upanishad going to speak in different way. We cannot catch the actual inner meaning. Srutaya vivinna, and naso muni rajasya matam na min, there is no such muni, naso munir, and matam na bhinna, there is no such sadhu, no such muni. Sadhu, this word I cannot use, because sadhu is only applicable for Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, see sadhu, this word. So, in Mahabharata it is written, naso muni rajasya matam na bhinna. Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking, Nasho Munir, one such muni, you cannot find. Sadhu also, there is some difference in representation, if they are at all going to follow their Sadguru properly, otherwise we cannot use this title for them. You can point out that Sadhu speaking, that I cannot. When they are in the line of Sautapanta, try to understand, when I am speaking, standard thing. You cannot give me example, Mahadev Maharaj doing this, I am less interested. I don't like to hear anything. Whenever I am speaking standard, you will have to consider it properly, understand. So, if they are all appropriately in Sautapanta, but anyway, Prabhupada already and told us that if somebody going to get deviated from Sautapantha, they can they can lose their existence. Even they can have big influence in the society. They can say that I am a great preacher. Thousands of temple can be there. It matters little. It matters little. It's not a big factor. It is not a big factor. What you say? Yes, it is one kind of karma kanda. When pure Sadhguru Vaishnava going to approve one temple and deity, then it is not karma kanda. Out of my own fanciful idea, I like to make one temple in England. What you can do? You cannot maintain yourself. You cannot guide yourself. You are in Maya. You are going to make another Maya center, Saturday club, Sunday club. What you can do? You can arrange a pure radical. Temple mean, Prabhupada wanted to say, temple mean mobile temple, Gauriya Sadhu. They are actually temple. If that kind of sadhu is not there in a temple, it is not at all temple. It is mandir. They can go on to, and even mandir, how I can say, if there is all rubbish they are doing. Mandir means there should be, purity should be there at least. So it's not a matter of joke. So when they are going to follow Sautapantha in toto, maybe their representation is a little bit different. I can never say that Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj is just out of Sautapantha. I cannot say. I don't have that much audacity. I cannot say that Kesava Goswami Maharaj is out of Sautapantha. Simply because their representation is different. Not that. So when Kesava Goswami Maharaj is speaking, when Sridhara Goswami Maharaj is speaking, when the Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj is speaking, when Bhakti Swarup Siddhanta Goswami Maharaj is speaking, they are Sautapantha. They are in the line Sautapantha. For them I am speaking. At all, if they are going to leave the Sautapantha, Sautapantha means leaving Prabhupada, leaving Gaudiya Math, everything they are going to leave. Everything is going to make a separate rules and regulation. Then it is already approved. So we are going to say that they are deviated from Sautapantha, so they are fallen. Those who are deviated from Sautapantha, they can fall down. No way. How they can maintain themselves? Ultimately they can fall down. So those who are in Sautapantha, for them I am speaking. So their representation can be different, but they are not going to speak against Sautapantha. All their Siddhanta, Vichar, everything, and all, more or less, representation, a little bit difference can be there, but all same. So you see, Naso Munir Jasamatam Naminyam. Naso, there you cannot find such a sadhu, such a muni, whose, siddha, whose vichar is his vichar is not different from others. They are going to differ from each other. Like, I can give the example, in front of Parikshit Maharaj, so many Rishi Muni from different marg, they are coming to get together in that spot. Some going to give advice about karma mark, some going to give advice about karma, varnas, different, karma arpan, different. Procedure yoga, dhyanjo, ganjo, different kind of procedure they are going to advise to Parikshit Maharaj. But Parikshit Maharaj anyway not getting any satisfaction. But when Sukadeva Goswami coming, then everybody they are going to give honor to him, pay honor to him. Because Sukadeva Goswami, now at present actually going to act as a Bhakti Acharya. Previously, it was one kind of Leela actually, Actually it is, I can discuss that, Gyan Mishra Bhakti, Gyan Sunna Bhakti, all when I can go discussing, then I can also give the topics. I can speak the topics of Hiranyakasipu, Ravan. They are also Gyani. Ravan, they are also Gyani. But actually that kind of knowledge we don't need. We like to throw away that kind of knowledge. Jarasandha also, having knowledge. But that knowledge we don't want. We like to throw away. Ravan Nirvisheshvad, Ravan Nirvisheshvad, Kumbhakarna, all Nirvisheshvad. Jarasandha Nirvisheshvat, Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyak, they are all Nirvisheshvat, impersonal Brahman. They are doing everything, I can discuss. They are doing Archan, Jagya, everything, Maharaj. But I already, that's why today I thought I should start with this point. So that basically they can find the difference, you know, between those Rakshas and Asuras and those, you know, those who are going to follow Bhagavad Dharma, at least. So that's why I was bound to discuss this point, that kaeno vacha manasendhyarva buddhvatmana bhavanushyato sabhavat karoti yad yad sakalam parasmai narayaneti samarpayata. That is why I was bound to speak this slok, so that you can understand. Hiranyakashipu Hiranyaksho Ravan Kumbhakarno Jarasandho, they are not at all going to give, you know, the result of karma unto lotus feet of Narayana or Vishnu. Not at all. They are not going to do. Kayeno vacha, with body, speech and mind, any kind of karma. Kayeno vacha manasendhyarva, by sense organ, applying sense organ. Whatever they are doing. Buddhvatmana ba anusritasa, anusritasavabhadmane, by out of his natural instinct. He is a bad habit, he is doing something, a good habit, doing something. Out of his natural instinct, man. Kayeno manasa, you know, everything actually, manasa indiyarva, buddhvatmana ba anusrita. Buddhvatmana by applying intellect, buddhvatmana, ba unusthita sabhava. Unusthita by, you know, according to his previous, you know, out of his natural instinct he is doing this, you know, because of Maya. Whatever you are doing, whatever you buddhatmana ba unusthita sabhavat, it all should be offered unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Otherwise, you are going to take the responsibility of what wrong or right, whatever we are doing, you are going to take responsibility for that. Even Harikatha, I cannot make any Siddhanta, I cannot manufacture any Siddhanta. I have no right to manufacture any Siddhanta, I have no right, no right. Only I can represent all my previous Guru Varga. I can say that Prabhupada told this, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, if I am going to at all, man, going to produce or manufacture one Siddhanta, then surely I can fall down with all my groups. Because our Guru Varga never told that. I am going to manufacture in my, you know, in my brain. It's a devil's workshop. Devil's workshop. Ideal Ben is a devil's workshop. Is ideal Ben mean? Here, ideal, I can say, ideal mean is not at all interested to do anything Guru Seva, Vaishnava Seva. He is preaching, he is doing everything. But it is not Guru Seva, it is personal Seva. You can show Maharaj is preaching, okay, preaching. But it is his personal Seva. If I am not going to speak what Prabhupada told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, it is not at all preaching, whatever, how much, you know, whatever amount of endeavor, energy, maybe is going to put. It's not prachar. Because out of Sautopantha is fallen soul. He is going to fall down with all, he himself or all the followers there. So it cannot so happen. So exactly those who are Sautopantha for them. So what I am speaking in this sloka, that buddhvatmanava anushyato sabhavat, whatever you are going to do, you will have to offer unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Otherwise, you will have to take all responsibility. So I cannot manufacture any Siddhanta. Because in that case, I will have to take responsibility. Whatever, you know. So I will have to take the responsibility. This is a big problem. So Prabhupada very often used to speak that our speaking Harikatha is one kind of action. Activities, I mean the duty done by a peon. Peon, you know, post office peon. Post office peon going to deliver letters door to door. whatever message coming here, he has nothing to do, only he is going to deliver the letter intact way. Not even going to open the letter reading, no, he has no right. Prabhupada is going to give this example that our speaking Harikatha is one kind of duty, just like a postman. We are going to discharge our duty, our Guru Varga giving you this envelope, you give this letter to that man, there, this house, that house. So that we are doing, if we are going to take, do something separately, then all responsibility can come on me. If I am going to speak all exactly what Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, if anybody going to attack me, it is the responsibility of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur Nityananda Prabhu to protect me. Not that I can speak this way, everybody can attack me, so I should stop speaking that kind of absolute truth. That is called idiot. This kind of preacher is idiot preacher. Simply because every whole world cannot like me, they can attack me. Arey Maharaj, someday they can understand. Someday, maybe not this life, next life, they can understand. But still I am not going to change my Siddhanta. Then if I am speaking this way, absolute way, then the total responsibility going into the hand of Nityananda. I mean into the hand of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. They can protect me. Let people attract me. Let me see what they can do, what harm they can do. This way actually exact Sauta Pantha will have to follow. So, Naso Munir Jasamatam Navinyam. So what? What is the procedure? But that's why we are speaking, Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking. You cannot find out any two rishi. I cannot point out that they are rishi, they are both of their, you know, decision is okay, perfect, similar, you cannot point out. So what is the procedure then? But that is why the advice given by Yudhishthira Maharaj, Mahayano Yeno Gato Sapantha. So we will have to depend upon Mahayana. Mahayana means basically 12 Mahayana I already told. Basically, 12th Mahajana is there. You have to. So, 12th Mahajana originally there, they are all following Bhagavad Dharma. That doesn't mean I can follow only the procedure shown by Prahlad Maharaj. I cannot. I am less interested in the procedure shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Not that, Rupa Goswami. You will have to be, you know, very careful. What? Nautamada Guru wanted to speak in his Kirtan, Parthana Pembakti Chandiga, Mahajaner Jaipath Purvapar Kuriya Vichar. Mahajaner Jaipath, after that ... after the Mahajaner Seipath, Mahajaner Jaipath ... after that is the last line is written, Purvapar Kuriya Vichar. What is the meaning? Basically, Mahajan is there. But those Mahajan, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, they are going to give more filtered way, Bhagavad Dharma, more accurately, fine and fine. Regarding Seva, they are also pure. Not that I am not pure, but regarding the accuracy and the procedure of Seva, through each day by day, you know, so that day by day we can try to satisfy Supreme Lord the best possible way. The procedure shown by Gopikas is the final. You know, there is the final procedure. So, Brajavadhu Vargena Jakarpita. So, I already discussed, no? The Maha. Brajavadhu Vargena Jakarpita. Brajavadhu Vargena Jakarpita. Aradha Bhagavana Vajasastanayasta Dhamma Vrindavanam. Ramma kachidu pasana prajapati vargena yakalpita simad bhagavatam pramanam amalam premapumartha mahano siman mahapur matam idam na tatradaro na para tatradaro na apara. Here Mahaprabhu wanted to show us that this is my vichar, my siddhanto, I like it. So Supreme Lord, when going to point out, we have to understand. So, actually, there is a kirtan, they are written, Bhaktivinoda, Northumbrag wanted to speak that Purvapar Kuriya Vichar. Mahajana jai pat, sei pat habo anugato, but one condition, Purvapar Kuriya Vichar. We'll have to make one very, you know, adjustment. Previous Mahajan, what they told, and present Mahajan going to show us this way, there should be a nice bridging soon, so that we can understand. Basically, we are going to honor them, Mahajan, Mahajano Yeno Vatu Sapanta. That is the way, track we will have to follow. And there is no problem. Otherwise, there can be big problem in our life. Now, the question, you know, of Nimi Maharaj was Parasya Vishnur Rishasya Mainam Opi Mahinim Mayam Veditum Ichhamo Bhagavantam Brumantuna. Please, you are Navajugandha 9 Jogendra, they are all coming here. Parasya Vishnur, for absolute, you know, Supreme Lord Vishnu, Tasho Mane, his Maya is so strong that Maya re Kuriya Jai Charanona Jai. Only the medicine is the Kripa of Guru Sadhguru Vishnu. Repeatedly I am going to remind you, don't try to forget it. And it is written, Mainam Api Mahinim. Shankar Bhagavan, Varun, they can create Maya, big Maya. They have their power. Like, you know, when Prithu Maharaj's yoga going on, then Indra Maharaj going to make different kind of Maya, going to steal the horse, so that Prithu Maharaj cannot complete his 100 yoga. Shatakratu. Shatakratu is the name of Indra. Indra Maharaj is the only personality who is going to enjoy this title, Shatakratu. Shatakratu means hundreds of yajna. Ashwamedh yajna he has done in his life. 100. And nobody can break this record. If somebody is going to break record, they are putting jealousy. Jealousy everywhere. Even in Bhajan field, there is also jealousy. They are actually not, those who are having jealousy, they are not surely not doing bhajan. In the sports game, in the field of education, in the field of politics too, of course. Every sphere of life, without politics, without jealousy, we cannot find one place which is just pure, where I can get very nice chance to discuss Harikatha, enjoy with all devotees in front of. It's a rare chance. Almost impossible. At present, the whole world is so intoxicated. You know, intoxicated with our Maya, 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 position, love, puja, patishta, Maya, everything, I and me. They cannot tolerate that any other pure sadhu going to do something good, they don't allow. Even, you know, Prabhupada, they are going to attack Prabhupada. Even inside the group of his disciples, they also went against him. They have done so many mistakes, they have done so many, you know, like Asur, he has done. So it's quite natural. Jesus Christ is also going to point out, among you, one of you can indicate, give information to the king about me. Maybe his name is Judas. I forget. Long ago I read now, Bible. So this way, everywhere, every time, there is some jealousy, there is some intoxication, everything, all problem, fighting mood. But this jealousy is not there with pure Guru Vishnu. That is why we are always searching for pure Guru Vishnu. Why? Why? Because all other Sadhu Guru Vishnu cannot purify us. Why we are always crying and searching for pure Guru Vishnu? Because only they can purify. Because they are pure. If there is any jealousy, contamination there, inside heart, for love, puja, patishta, then, you know, some envious attitude against pure guru, there is already contamination there. They can preach raganuga, rupanuga, whatever they like, but their preaching is absolutely flop. Flop preaching. It's not preaching, it's not an actual preaching. They can die. This way actually, so, actually, Mahayana Yeno Gato Sapantha. So, we are interested to find out because we are discussing about Bhagavad Dharma. Gradually, we are going to enter into Bhagavad Dharma and to reach the final goal shown by Mahaprabhu with the help of Sri Rai Ramananda. In Bhagavatam, in the starting of Bhagavatam, you can find Nirmat Saranam Satam. Don't try to forget this point. Any amount of, you know, philosophy you can hear from different here and there, very excellent philosophy, you can dance. You can go on dancing and Maya can also help you dance, help you to dance. Whole life, life after life. Dancing means that kind of dancing. You go on dancing. You cannot get any solution. Mayadevi can force you to dance in Saturday club, Sunday club, you know. Opening all clothes and everything. Yes, yes, very nice. You know, very nice dancing. But you cannot get any clue of Bhagavad Dharma. That's why in the beginning of Bhagavad Dharma, maybe tomorrow I can, or day after tomorrow I can discuss. It is Nirma Saranam Satam. This Bhagavad Dharma is only for those sadhu, those who are having no envious attitude. They are having no fighting attitude, envious attitude, nothing. Envious attitude means, suppose my son, my daughter, you know, they are going to do bhajan nicely. If I discover, oh, they are doing bhajan, so I can make some, you know, some problems so that they cannot do bhajan. It is called mascharya. Suppose some sadhu going to do bhajan properly, going to show the exact way, less interest about money, position, everything, nothing. Only he like to represent Prabhupada and Bhakti Mutha. If somebody going to express a jealous attitude means he is unable. He is unable to bear the kind of improvement seen in that devotee. That kind of excellency at present we can see, you know, with, you know, Kesav Goswami, with Siddhar Goswami, we cannot tolerate. That's why you can go against him. This is called jealousy. If this kind of mood is there, then in infinity period you can go on doing bhajan. So long as you have this kind of mood, you can never come out successful, at least in Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma is not for you, if you have jealousy. So, Nirma Saranam Satam, you should remember. So, Narottama Thakur what wanted to say, that Mahajano Jeno Gato Sapandha, it's right. But Mahajano Jeva, that path is, originally it is all okay. But finally, when my present Guru Bhargava going to show me more fine way, curate way to follow this bhajan path, bhajan track, so that I can give full satisfaction to Supreme Lord. Yeah. So, this way you'll have to make some. So, this way actually Narottama Thakur wanted to give this advice so that we can understand that Mahajano Jano Gita Sapantya. Now this question, when Nimi Maharaj is going to put in front of, you know, Navayugendra, they like to know about Maya. What is Maya? I already explained, you know, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, the Sarva Shakti, the internal potency of Supreme Lord, is the original Shakti, but except that another Shakti is can be seen in this material world, but except that original Shakti, this Shakti can lose her existence. That's called Maya. Very easy representation. So, we can come into this conclusion. that Bhaktivinoda was speaking, the internal maya, internal potency, internal jogamaya sakti is a maya sakti, is original sakti, except that due to that maya sakti present in the eternal world, there we can feel some another sakti acting. But it is the shadow of that sakti. Varai from Brahma Sangita already told, Chaye vajasya bhuvanani bhuvanani vivarti durga, sishti sita vipalaya sadhana sakti reka, Chaye vajasya bhuvanani vivarti durga, I already told. This chaya, shadow, not actual. So here in this shadow world, in this world it is negative. That is why I told repeatedly this world is negative. Because it is shadow. Any amount of honor you are getting, any amount of education you are getting, you are doing some research work, you are scientist, any amount of, you know, what you are doing, I can prove, I already told maybe 2 years back, I cannot remember, that they are doing everything. But original Shakti is there. Original, and they are shadow. That's why they are according to the gesture of Maya, indication of Maya Shakti, Mahamaya Shakti, they are dancing. They don't understand what is Jogamaya Shakti. They don't understand even today. That's why actually Bhaktivinoda was speaking, original Shakti there is shadow Shakti, shadow falling here. The shadow, you know, also some devotees once from Spain, very nice devotee, he is going to put question in different way. He is putting different kind of question. I am going to answer you very quickly. You know, so you can understand the how it is possible that in Bhagavatam here there are different kind of hell, heaven and hell description there. So there in Bhagavatam written, is it fictitious or allegory? No, I can show you indications here. So in, you know, here the shadow is Durga. Same Maya is same, but sometime acting as Mahamaya, sometime acting as Jogamaya. It according to time and circumstances is, you know, giving service, you know, this way. So now in front of Navayugandha, Nimi Maharaj wanted to ask, Parasya Vishnu Rishasya Mainam Upi Mahinim. Even Shankar Bhagavan is hypnotized, you know. When Shankar Bhagavan was bound to drink all the poison, halahal beast, then you can know Mahini Murti, Mahini Avatar. Bhagavan took the form of a very, very beautiful, you know, lady, very, you know, you cannot just, you know, so Bhagavan also writing in Bhagavatam in different way, to in front of Buddha also giving explanation. So even Shankar Bhagavan asking, well, oh Prabhu, I like to see your Maya, I like, oh, what you can do? I heard that if that time I was unconscious, I was, you know, by your mercy I was drinking poison, so I was unconscious. But I like to see that. What you can do is useless. No, 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 no. I like to see your Maya. Ah, you like to see Maya? Oh. Okay. I can show you someday. Then very shortly, you know, Shankar Bhagavan, Devi Maya, Devi Durga, all, you know, Nandi, Biringi, all troop, full troops with Shankar, suddenly discover one very, very beautiful lady. She is playing one ball and dancing, just like when moving here and there, he is dancing, just like dancing, very nice, sweet dancing. So we see. Shankar Bhagavan is hypnotized, want to look very carefully. Finally, Shankar Bhagavan forget that just left side, his wife's Durga's, you know, standing, forget, running behind that Maya. I like to catch that lady, very beautiful lady. And Shankar Bhagavan running. This is ultimately when that lady was in the grip of Shankar, Then that lady expresses original Saru. Bhagavan speaking, what happened, Sambhu? You are Kamjayi. You already, you know, Mittunjayi, Kamjayi. Oh, oh my God. And he feels shy. Then feels shy. Prabhu, you? Yes. You wanted to see my Maya, what I can do? I wanted to avoid showing this kind of Maya to you. We forcefully want to see. Oh my God. He was feeling shy. Okay. And Sambhu, you are Kamjayi. You are Mittunjayi. Also, you are affected by my... You see, my, that's why it is written, you know, Maya Bedudu, you want to get right information about that Maya. Because it is Maina Mopi Mohinim. Those who can, Indra, Varun, Sankha, they can also show some Maya in front of us. Even Rishi Muni also can show. So, that's why to prove this point, we can find that sometime Rishi Muni, they are also going to be influenced by the attraction shown by Mayadevi. Bhagavan sometimes sending. Urvashi, Menaka, Urvashi, Vasishtha Muni, you know, Menaka, Durvasa, you know, Vishwamitra Muni affected. They are feeling attraction. They are feeling attraction to prove that it is so too much Maya everywhere. But I can give evidence that a pure devotee can never feel any amount of Maya can be there. Any amount of havoc Maya can be there. But it can do no harm to pure. I can give the example of Haridas Thakur. Mayadevi herself coming in from in Fulia. Also Mayadevi coming in different from Lakshayira Pras. But anyway, they could not influence, they could not change the mood of Haridas Thakur. It is not possible. They could not change the mood of Haridas Thakur, it is not possible. Because in pure devotional practice there is such an pure attraction. So that's why he started with this point that Prabhupada very often used to say, we should get out of the influence of the attraction and repulsion of Maya, shown by Maya. If we are not going to cut this kind of Maya, we can do bhajan for thousands of years. What happens? Maya Rekurya, still Maya is there. So, Rishi Muni, they are also feeling attraction. Even Shankar Bhagavan also. That is the excellent Maya. Oh, powerful. Nobody can compare. Mami vaje prapadante maya metam taranti. Etam maya te taranti je janaha. You know, this way. You know. Mami vaje prapadante maya metam taranti te. They can only and only, they can cut maya. Those who are going to surrender unto my lotus feet perfectly. Still today we have no perfect definition of saranagati. We don't understand. We are showing saranagati. But exactly what Jiva Goswami Pada wanted to say, we don't understand. But this kind of we read. We read, we are speaking so much sloka, everything. You know. Yesterday also told you, no? Those who are going to get kipa, Jisham Saesha Bhagavan Dayaeda Ananto Sarvatmana Sita Vadam Jodini. Okay. But exact definition, I like to feel from my heart. Because without direct realization, any amount of philosophy cannot stand inside my heart. If I am going to get kippa of Guru Vaishnava, then I can digest. Otherwise, no digestion. Indigestion of Harikasa, indigestion of Tattva Vigyan can make more trouble in your life. Be careful. And Prabhupada speaking, it is quite natural. Inside a bonded soul, like, you know, All bonded soul, they are sometime, they, we can find their awakening stage, they are not sleeping. Sometimes they are sleeping, but sometimes they are showing they are in awakened condition. They are doing everything, material activities. Prabhupada writing in his Patrabali, one of his letter. The letter actually, the heading of the letter was Jive Sabhave Mukto, in the nature of bonded soul, both bonded and mukta avastha is there. There is a heading. Actually, it is one letter. In the letter, Prabhupada writing, inside a Baddhaji, we can find both in an awakening condition and sleeping condition, similarly, in a bonded soul, it is quite natural they have their bonded bhava, bonded condition, and mukta avasthat doy already there. Already there. I can explain this point when jivatma, they eternally, eternal jivatma and their sarupa, and discussing for long time, maybe 1 year, I am not discussing. So, halfway it is lying. Final conclusion I can draw, then I can again discuss in clearly, so that there is no confusion. So, Prabhupada, what Prabhupada wanted to say, inside Baddha Jeev, there is this kind of, you can find the awakening condition and sleeping condition, both we can find time to time. So, inside a bonded soul, there is both bonded bhava and mukta bhava already there. It's not that when mukta bhava, only Sadhuguru Vaishnava going to help that jivatma to achieve that state. Already there. I already told, a jivatma in sarupa is a gyanamaya vastu. I already know chidatma, jivatma is chidatma, sarupata, and it is full of knowledge. Already there. Only Guru Vaishnava can help the jivatma to cut bondage and discover their own original condition. So, Prabhupada speaking in his letter, Baddha Jiva Savabe, in the Savab of Baddha Jiva habit, there is a bonded condition and Mukta Avastat Doi, Bogi or Tagi, both condition is there. Bhakto, eternally those who are, Krishna Seva, eternally they are Mukta, for them no question, this is not applicable for them. But those who are Bhakta, sadhan, through their bhajan, they are trying to get bhakti. Bhakta, through bhajan, they have to cut bonded condition, after that enter into the field of seva, bhajan, then they can ultimately can get siddhi, eternal seva they can get. Then no problem. So, Prabhupada speaking in the sabhav, nature of bonded soul, both the conditions are there. So, sometime bonded soul showing this mood, sometime that mood. In the case of Ajamil, we can find Ajamil was very good, showing some positive mood, but again negative mood. This way, many times we can find. So many examples I can give, sometime positive mood, sometime negative mood. Why? But so, because this Baddha Bhav and Mukta Bhav is already there inside Ajiva. Baddha Bhav, Mukta Bhav mean Bhogi and Tagi. Bhog Bhav and Tagi Bhav. Both of that Bhog and Tabo Bhav we like to throw away. We don't need. Bhog and Tag. Bhog means enjoyment and detachment. Both we are less interested. We like to show Yukta Vairagya through which we can get the scope to do serve Supreme Lord the best possible way. Why those devotees, they are going to do, make some negative thing? Already I told that tomorrow also I can discuss. Abhish Sriti Krishna Pada Ravindir, this I can discuss tomorrow. And Narottama Thakur, out of his humble attitude, Narottam Thakur, out of his humble attitude, is going to write this kirtan to show us, to teach us, only to teach us. You know, only to teach us, not that he is in bondage condition. He is eternally present, Champaklata, eternally there, eternal seva in both in Gaurdham and in Brajadham. In Brajadham, in the form of Champaklata, and here itself in the form of, you know, Narottama Thakur is a Gaur Parsad. So when Narottama Thakur is going to write in Parthana, Kirtan, Hari Hari Kipakuri Rakho Nijo Pade, Kama Kodo Chhaye Jani, Laya Phire Nana Sthane, Vishaye Bhunjaye Nana Mathe, Haiya Mayar Das Kori Nana Uvilas, Tomas Moron Gelo Dure, Arthalav Eya Se Kapat Vaishnav Beshe, Bhramiya Bule Ghare Ghare. You have to go through Parthana Pranambachita, definitely you have to go. An explanation, if you like to hear, you have to give me separate time. Parthana Pranambachita Chandika, or, you know, Upadeshamrita, Manasiksha, all separate is here to so clearly, you will have to understand. Very clearly you will have to understand. If there is confusion in your understanding, then whole bhajan is mistake. Like in mathematics. In mathematics you are doing for 1 hour, 1 and 2 hours, one mathematics solution. Because those who are having mathematics honors, they are doing mathematics. I have my experience, but I forget today, I cannot remember. I forget everything. By that time, you'll have to do one mathematical solution, you'll have to 1 hour, 2 hours, you know. But if I make some basic mistake in the beginning, I can give my energy for 2-3 hours, but I cannot come out successful. That is the point. Mathematics is such a thing, if you are going to put exactly, you can get full marks. And those teachers, they cannot cut any 1 mark, 2 mark, no. If mathematics is full okay, then he is bound to give full marks. But regarding literature, this that you have to, they can cut mark. They cannot give full mark. But mathematics is such a thing. If you are right 100%, they are going to give. If you are wrong, then zero. Maharaj, up to this point I was wrong, they are not going to hear anything. Maharaj, up to this point I was successful to write. Why they are not going to give me half mark? No. Wrong means wrong. If your understanding is wrong, you are not going to follow pure Guru wisdom. Only you took diksha from such a sadhu. I cannot speak. Then whole life you are going to make mistake and your bhajan is totally wrong. Ram bhajan is not good. You know. So now Narottama Thakur going to write that way, we should not think that Narottama Thakur is bonded so. He is writing to show us the way of bhajan. How much Srinadapi, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing in Bhajan Rahasya. Hoilo sarvagune guni mahasay patishthasa tajikaro amani hidai. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Maybe we know that sadhu is full of different qualities. All different qualities are there inside. But still, hoilo sarvagune gunima, different kind of unique qualities are there inside him. But still, he is going to show humble mood. I am useless, I have done nothing. Krishna Das Kavira Jose, I am useless, I have done nothing, I could not again. This way, very humble attitude. Rupa Goswami Pad Rai, Barako Opi, Barako Rupa Opi. And, you know, going to take, you know, that kind of endeavor to compile this Rasamrita Sindhu. Hridi yasso peranaya, you know, pavartityaham, barakarupopi. This is by the mercy and inspiration of that Supreme Lord, Gaur Hari, I am going to take, you know, I am going to put some energy, you know, to compile this Rasamrita Sindhu. Though I am unfit, totally unqualified, but it's a causeless mercy of Supreme Lord, what to do? This way actually, Narottama Thakur actually, out of his humble mood writing this way, actually bonded soul due to his Bhagavad Vishruti. When he is going to forget? Avishruti Krishna Padaravinda Yur, I can discuss. Chinoti Avadrani Chas, I can discuss. So Bhagavad Vishruti, when they are going to cut their link, actually, somehow, he is going to show some link. He is doing the Ajamil link. But that link was a very weak link. That's why there was no Chitbal, was sufficient Chitbal was not with him. That's why he was fallen down. So Prabhupada speaking, they are going to forget their eternal dharma, chit dharma, chit particle, jiva, you know, they are chinmay, ganamay. So it is already there in them, not that they will have to buy from some outside. So when they are going to forget their eternal duty, then they, and those who are going to forget eternally, Krishna Bholi Seijib Anadi, when they are going to forget, I already explained and again I can explain, there are two categories of jeeps. One eternally going to serve Supreme Lord, they never saw any Maya, they have no experience about Maya, and those eternally bonded. It is the arrangement of Supreme Lord, there is playing going on. And also, it is Supreme Lord going to give both bhav inside them. One is bonded so that they can feel inspiration to serve Maya. Both. Also, there is another bhav. Then, Mukta Avastha is also there. These two type of condition can be there. Both the Avastha, they can feel inspiration to serve Maya. They can feel. And Mukta Avastha, they can come to a neutral position also. So, when they can meet with pure Sadhguru Vaishnava, then they can change their mood. You know, Brahmanda Vaitakunam Bhagavan Jeev, Guru Krishna Prasade Paya Bhakti Latabhi. In that case, they can change their mood. That is the. So, actually, Prabhupada writing in his letter, these both possibilities are there in Bhada Jiva. And Saranagati, what do you mean by Saranagati? Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing explanation of one sloka from Rasamrita Sindhu, Ya kenapi oti bhagyena yatro shraddho asho sevane, kasho sevane, bhagavat sevane. Iswarasya sevane. So, ya kenapi oti bhagyena yato sradhyo asya sevane nati shakto na vairagyo bhaga asyam adhi karja aso. Those who are ultimately not going to feel too much attraction, asakti no attachment, they are sangsar, nitantosh, anasakto, Hoya, anasakto, they have no attraction in this family life, in material life. You know, they are at present, ya kenapi oti bhagyena. At present, still today, they are not growing that kind of detachment. But their detachment is there, not that kind of, that kind of detachment, not there. Full-fledged form, not there. So, in that case, you know, their vairagya is not, still today not perfect. So, even today they are not going to show total detachment. Asakta now, attachment is not there and full vairagya is not there. Then luckily, when they grow some mood, luckily, if they can grow that kind of mood, bhagya krame, Krishna Sabha Shraddha Janme, Bhakti Mukhi Sukriti. In that case, Shuddha Bhakti Adhikari Bulian, in that case, he can try and, you know, I mean, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak that when Sansari Purush, in course of his leading Sansar, Varnasam Dharma, something, someday, because of painful experience, someday he is going to get grow detachment. Oh, useless! I have seen enough of it. Propirito, Artho, oh my God! This correction, and always thinking, you know, that this family, this, you know, this material life is unstable, nothing. And I wanted to get this thing, that kind, that thing, this thing. But I couldn't arrange because my luck was not favorable for that to get. So ultimately, this is the ultimate goal. So somehow they are going to grow detachment fully and leading their life. And after that, they are going to grow final question. That is called Athoto Brahma Jigyasa. They now feel without this Tattva Jigyasa, Athoto Tattva Jigyasa, Athoto Brahma Jigyasa, who am I? Without this question unto the lotus feet of a pure sadhu, there is no other way for Jiva to come out successful. Charam Jigyasa, it is called absolute question. This question, why not coming inside you? That is why Sukhdev Goswami was very, very, very happy to hear the question of Parikshit Maharaj. And Gurudev, Guru Pat Padmo, Sukhdev Goswami, Paramahansa Guru, he was very happy. He was so happy, so happy, so happy that he was bound to an appreciate disciple. That's why he is speaking. Baryane shate prasno kito lok hito nipaha atmavit sanmataha pungsam shatabhyadhi shujaparaha. He was bound to speak that way. He is glorifying his disciple. You know, your question is, Rajan, excellent question. Baryane shate prasno kito lok hito nipaha. You have done this kind of question. And this question ultimately going to distribute mangal among thousands of people, jivatma, in future and present. So Parikshit Maharaj, in front of Parikshit Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami was bound to speak, bound to appreciate. Gurudev going to appreciate. Baryanesha te prasne, it's a very topmost question. Baryanesha te prasno, your question is an excellent question. Krito loko hito nipaha. You are going to put this question because you like to arrange good for all society. Paryanesho te prasno krito loko hito nipaha. So that all bonded soul can get some facility. Mangal. Atma, and not only that, but also it is approved by Atmabit. Atmabit. Atmabit means those who are having full tatagyan. Without having complete tatagyan, nobody can become atma tatabit. You know, some half tatabit we can see, but atma tatabit means a master of tatabit. What is good, what is bad, what is maya, what is Bhagavan, what is jivatma, what is condition, all someone they can give you answer very quickly. You know, they can give answer. They can cut all of your doubts and suspicion very easily. So, Baryane sate prasna kito loko hita napaha atmabit sanmataha pungsam. All this question is approved by all atmatattabit purush. Big personality, gigantic personalities in the way of bhajan, as you know, spiritual line. So Atmabit Sanmata Pungsam Sratabhyadishu Japaraha. Whatever you can expect to hear, whatever, maybe you like to hear physics, you like to hear chemistry, you like to hear mathematics, geography, whatever knowledge, legal process, anything. anything, even so-called bhajan procedure, karma, jnana, there's so many things we are hearing, which is the, preliminary procedure, step by step we have to go. But atmadhi sannato means sotobhyadishu. What all you can expect in your life to hear, this question is so topmost question that they can have the chance to hear the answer of this question to arrange their mangal. Surely. Atmavit sanmatoha pungsam sotabhyadisu japaraha. So, there should be final question in my life to grow detachment. Without that, no jivatma can forcefully, you can, make them tilak, mala, everything and give them, they can make some ravis. Because they don't understand. The enjoying mood is there. Your harikatha not going to cut their enjoying mood. If there is powerful sadhu, like Naraji Maharaj, he can cut readily, can cut all bondage. No need of expiation, no need of jagya, nothing. Only nam yaga. Hey! Naraji Maharaj speaking, you just break your bow and arrow. What I can eat? I am arranging my, daily bread. No, I can give you. You break it. And come to me, I can arrange your daily bread. Oh, really? That's going to break. It was Naraji, try to remember. It's Naraji, the great Acharya. By the influence of Naraji, that the mood of that, that hunter was totally changed. It is a magic spell. It's a magic spell, Because he was doing so much papa, but aparadha was not even a single aparadha was there in his life. That's why he was excused and he got solution, because any amount of papa you have done in your life, you can get rid by the help of namabhas. That doesn't mean you can do namabhas and every day you can do some, some papa and every morning you can do namabhas. Not that. Not that. Not that. This is not a procedure. You have to understand the exact thing, exact tattva. So, tattva jigyasa is a must. If tattva jigyasa is not going to grow inside my heart, because inside the tattva jigyasa, there is a final, tendency of jiva to get out of this bondage of maya is seen, we can see. Well, then you can grow shuddha, and shuddha, harikatha kirtan, you are hearing, you are going to understand something. After that, you are going to cut all your, attraction for karma, everything. What I was speaking, you can remember, jato shraddho mat kathasu nirvinyaha sarva karmasu. I already told. So now, Jiva Goswami Pada speaking, Saranapatti kake bole. What do you mean as Saranapatti? Jiva Goswami Pada speaking, Jatanam Sraddhayanam, Jatayam Sraddhayam Sadat Tadanubritti Chestraivo Sat. Karmo Parityago Vidhiyate. But Jiva Goswami speaking, Jatayam, when he is already growing that kind of faith, Jatayam, Sraddhayam, Sada, Tadanu, Vritti, Chestuivasat. Non-stop effort to do something. Tadanu, Vritti, Tad mean, I already do Om Tat Sat, Tat mean Sadvastu, Sadbin mean Om, that is Brahma Vastu. Bhagavan, Jatayam, Sraddhayam, when is going desire, faith, for doing non-stop, seva, tadanubhritti, like to follow Sadhguru Vaishnava, to understand this, what is the procedure of bhakti, bhajan, then only and only target in his life is to satisfy Supreme Lord. So, Jatayam, Sraddhayam, sada tadanubritti. Not that 5 hours morning time is done. Now I cannot do. Not that. Sada tadanubritti chestoibo. That kind of effort can be seen inside that jivatma. Tadanubritti chestoibo sat. And karma automatically going away from his life. It is just like the changing of screen. Just like the changing of skin of a snack. A snack going to change his skin without any trouble. No pain is there. No pain is there. When snack going to change his new skin, old skin going to live, then without any pain, he is going to throw skin, previous skin. You know. So, don't think it is a matter of joke. When Rai Ramananda going to give this argument, Bhagavan actually giving example, karmarpan, you know, after that giving this kind of argument, then, you know, sarva dharmanam tyajya parityajya mamehi, it's not a matter of joke. We can speak. If I can take away from your daughter, then I like to see how he can bear. He can start crying. This way, son, daughter, this, that, so much affinity, attraction there. You know, though they are Vaishnava, if they are Vaishnava, if you are growing some, it's okay, but still, this kind of attraction, mune ropi dustajyo. Those who are munis, they cannot come. You know, this kind of, you know. So be careful. So sarva dharmanam parityajyo, mamekam saranam bhajo, not a matter of joke. It is not a matter of joking. So you will have to feel. From Bhagavatam I can give different kind of example. When you are going to offer everything to Supreme Lord, what you are going to offer, but about all what you like, everything you will have to for. So when Nimi Maharaj is going to put question, then Navajoganda going to give answer, Parasho Vishnur Ishasho Mahinamopi Mahinim Mayam Beditum Ichamu Ichamu. You know, Mayam Beditum Ichamu Bhagavantum Bhagavantum Brahmantanu. Please you trail in front of me. You know, please, I like to hear all about. And we like, what is Maya? First I explain already what is Maya, and they like to hear Maya, what is Maya. And second question, Nimi Maharaj putting, Je yathaitam aishwaring mayam. Yathaitam, so that, this kind of aishwari mayam, this great Maya, we can cut. How to pass away? Jataitam vaiswaring mayam dustaram kritatma bhi. Taranti anjaha sthulo dhiyo maharsho idamuchyatam. So many titles, you know, definition there. Jataitam, this kind of maya, vaiswarim, vaiswarim means it is Ishwar maya, not separately from Ishwar. And Shakti Shakti Mato Ravet, you should remember. So Jataitam Vaishwarim Maya. Is Maya not coming from Ishwar? Vaishwarim Maya. Ishwari Maya. Which is quite impossible to cross over. Maya we cannot cut. Dustaram Akritatmabhi, we have that, we that kind of, you know, Sukriti is not there. Power is not there with us. Dustaram akritatmabihi. And so that we can cut it very easily, would you please speak out the way, you know, the procedure, so that we can cut this maya. I know. It's quite impossible, next to impossible to cut that maya. But still, I like to get advice from you all, so that I can taranti anjaha. Anjaha means very easily I can cut. Would you please speak the way out? Sthulodhiyo, because our brain is, you know, material brain. Sthulodhiyo. Hey, Mahasayo, idam uchyata. Please, you speak out this procedure. What is the procedure through which I can approach and I can achieve success in my life? You should understand how to cut this maya. Then after that, one by one, we can get different kind of advice. You know, not one advice. Because all bonded souls, they are busy. They are always in group, not alone. About bonded soul, it is written, karmani arabhamananam dukchatvai sukhayacha pashet karma pashet pako viparyasam mithuni charinam ninam. What is the painful condition of those karmi people? But they are starting karma. Without karma, they cannot live. Karmanya arabha mananam. They are starting karma, doing karma all the time. Without karma, they cannot say, they are material personality. Karmanya arabha mananam. Why they are doing karma, Maharaj? What is their target? I was discussing analytically everything. Now, again, I like to discuss this point so that you can understand. They are doing karma. There is one target, to erase out, you know, they can arrange their happiness. Only target. Sukha sampatti aaye ghar ka, kashta mite tan ka, jai jagadishare. Sukha sampatti, all sukha, happiness and riches, you know, can come in our family life, in our life. And kashtami jetanka or bodily, you know, disease there, I can, you know, avoid. This is the target. So, karmanya arabha mananam, those who are starting their karma, their only target. Those who are varnasana dharma, those doing even. Those who are outside varnasana, they listen to, I am not, what I can do for them. Only for varnasana dharma, but still they are not doing varnasana dharma perfectly. Because I already explained for 2-3 days that final target of varnasana dharma is to satisfy Supreme Lord. If that not done, this is not, if not successful, then all karma is useless. Karma, it is double bondage. Karmanya arabha mananam dukcha atvai sukhayacha, to cut, this painful situation, we'll have to get rid of this painful situation, duksho. Painful situation. You have to cut this painful situation and arrange, happiness. That is your target. Karmanya arabha mananam duksho atvai shukhaya cha pashyat pako viparyasam. They wanted to do something good. But ultimately their luck is bad. They fail. You start one medicine factory. You are taking so much loan from bank here, there. Ultimately, you are failure, a bankrupt. You cannot pay. Their situation, you should realize this point. So, karmanya arabha mananam dukcha attai shukhaya cha pashyat paka viparyasan. They wanted to get some good result, but finally they meet with failure. They are doing this in group. Mithuni charinam ninam, this means, Viswanath Chakravarti is speaking, mithun means man and woman together. But this meaning we cannot take right now. A big meaning we should. Mithuni charin mane together. All together they are trying. Jointly they are trying to get success, to ensure their happiness. But they are foolish. This material world is unstable. Any kind of suffering or enjoyment what you are giving, all unstable. I already explained many times before. Jehi sangsparsaja bhogaha duksha yanayavati adyantabantakantiyo nateshu ramate buddha. Those who are really intelligent, they never go for sensual enjoyment. They are very intelligent. Those who are foolish, they can go and run and jump into fire and they can. So what is the procedure? So you have to, so many advice given by Navayugendra, but I have no time to discuss. Someday I can discuss. So you have to follow this Bhagavad Dharma. Atro Bhagavatano Dharmano Sikshet Gurvatma Devata. You will approach a pure guru who is already in Bhagavad Dharma, and you know this following Bhagavad Dharma. So then you can get advice from Navayugendra. Tatro Bhagavatana Dharmano Sikshet. You will have to learn this Bhagavad Dharma. You should not make any mistake. In the beginning, there is no possibility that you can follow perfect Bhagavad Dharma. You can make mistake. That's why I am discussing so big area, so that you can feel. Tatro Bhagavatana Dharmano Sikshet. You have to learn. Gurvatma Devyata, you have to, who is non-different from Supreme Lord, that type of guru, you know, you'll have to learn from him. How, what is the position? Amayayanu Britva. Without any maya, without any duplicity, you will have to follow Guru Vaishnava in toto. There should not be any smell of duplicity. Amayaya anubritva. First of all, amayaya, there should not be any duplicity. Anubritva means in toto. Whatever Guru Vaishnava speaking, you will have to do it. Anubritva. What they are doing, what they are speaking, you know, do this, you will have to do it. And by this procedure, you can joyous to shed atma atma dohari. I am advising you to follow this Bhagavad Dharma. Why? Through this procedure, Bhagavan, if you are successful, then Bhagavan going to sell himself in front of you. Really so? Yes, it is written. You know, that is why it is written, Amayaya Anupritva, joyous to shed atma atma dohari. Hari, Supreme Lord, Paratpar Akhileshwar, always standing in front of us. Somehow, he wants to sell himself in front of us. But we have no power to show that kind of loving, loveful mood so that we can buy the heart of Supreme Lord. So, I already told yesterday that those who are going to follow some procedure of Varnasam Dharma perfectly with a target to satisfy Supreme Lord, with Sravan, Kirtan, you know, everything, this Navida Bhakti, then they are okay. Then they can go. But Mahaprabhu, why Mahaprabhu was not satisfied by Mahaprabhu Singh? Actually, it is okay, but still it is not final thing. By this, so many contamination, who can come out successful? So you speak, I know. So after that, Rai Ramananda was bound to speak that Karmarpan, I already discussed yesterday. After Karmarpan, different kind of discussion, Rai Ramananda saying, okay, Mahapuja Karmarpan is okay. And from different angle, I was discussing about how we can make Karmarpan, and when Karmarpan is not perfect, contamination there, all I already discussed. Now, third, Rai Mahasaya is speaking, Shadharma Tag. When somebody going to leave all Shadharma, Varnasram Tag, Varnasram Dharma Tag. In that case, there is so many questions, because what is favorable, what is not favorable, it is a big issue. If you make mistake, then there is big problem. You cannot come out successful. So Karmarpan, you see, okay, is up to the gate of devotional field. Varnasram Dharma, if you are going to at all going to throw from heart, and that kind of maturity there, then no problem. Okay, you can try your best to do that. But Varnasram Dharma of Tag Purvak, Vaikantik, from heart, Vaikanthik means Prabhupada speaking, there is only one target. There is no second target. Prabhupada, tomorrow I can discuss. Prabhupada explaining. You know, Varnasam Dharma Tek Purbhog, after leaving Varnasam Dharma Prachesta, Tek Purbhog, Vaikanthik Bhave, Bhagavat Charane Prapannaha Saddhusa. When you are going to throw everything, you are less interested, Varna Ashram, everything, finally, Sarva Dharmanam Paritajya Mamekam Saranam Bhajo, these you are going to satisfy. If you can at all satisfy. Those who are satisfied, because there is called Prapanna Hava, it is called Saddhusar. That's why Ramananda speaking, Ramananda Raya speaking, leaving all this thing, when somebody is going to take shelter of the lotus feet, Prapanna, that is it is Saddhusar. It is the vital of sadhan, shaddo. Sadhan basad. You know, shaddo sar. Those who are externally going to follow Varnasam Dharma, I am not going to say. They are actually, or those who are going to busy with karmarpan, I already told, they are some, if there is any smell of, you know, false ego inside this karmarpan, still it is contaminated. Finally, Raya Mahasaya is going to give advice, give quote one sloka, because anyway, Varnasam Dharma, when they are going to live, you see in the society, our society, a condition of sannyas, brahmacharya, you see, at all they are not going to live anything. Totally they are double. You are in grihastha life now, I can pay honor to you. I cannot pay honor to them. If I can show their naked picture, but no solution. Who can find solution? Everybody can fight. So there is no solution. So, somebody can leave Varnasam Dharma, you know, somebody can leave Varnasam Dharma, they are going to take sannyas, this, that, so many things. But Prabhupada speaking, when they are not going to take sannyas from their heart, external danda and red cloth is not the evidence of my bhajan, sannyas dharma. Prabhupada explaining big way. Those who are going to take resolution in their life that my heart and soul I can try to serve Supreme Lord anyhow, any situation, any circumstance. They are from Tirandi Bhikkhuk, you can find from Bhagavatam. He is actually really, he genuinely has taken sannyas. But genuine sannyas and false sannyas, if you all are not going to cooperate with Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we can never come out safe. Or cheater people can eat up the vitals of our bhajan field. You will have to cooperate. We have to grow that kind of consciousness. You have to share the Harikatha with everybody. What kind of Harikatha you are hearing? You try to understand this so that you can realize what is wrong, what is right. The Harikatha, the kind of Harikatha which is going to misguide me, that is not at all Harikatha. Harikatha is that Harikatha which is going to increase my consciousness, my mood of bhajan, mood of seva, as called Harikatha. Already I told long, you cannot remember. Brahma speaking to Narad, you know, my son, you must be very careful. Jatha harau bhagavati, you know, so that they can grow bhakti unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Jatha harau bhagavati ninam bhakti bhavishvati. Be careful, you have to explain this Bhagavad Dharma with acharan. You have to show this way, so that anybody going to hear from you, if they are not aparadhi, they are going to change their life automatically. Jatha harau ninam bhagavati bhaktir bhavishvati. Ninam bhaktir bhavishvati. So that they can go bhakti mood. With this target, you have to go to preaching field. Otherwise, stop preaching field. We should stop preaching in the name of preaching also. Rubbish thing can be done. Now, Tomodago speaking, অর্থ লাভ এই আসে ঘনিয়া ফিলে দেশে দেশে উইথ এ ডিজায়ার টু কালেক্ট মানি অনলি রানিং হিয়ার এন্ড ইউ ক্যান সো ওয়ান অর টু পিপল ইউ আর সাকসেসফুল টু চেঞ্জ দেয়ার হার্ট ইভেন ইউ ক্যান চেঞ্জ ইউর ওন হার্ট হাউ ইউ আর গোয়িং রানিং হিয়ার এন্ড দেয়ার ইউ নো বা বিগ প্রিচার ফুলিশ হিরণ্যকশিপু হ্যাঁ নাও হিরণ্যকশিপু এন গন অ্যান্ড হিরণ্যাক্ষ গোয়িং টু পাস লেকচার ভাগবত তত্ত্ববিজ্ঞান টু ইজ মাদার মাদার অম্ব অম্ব দিস মেটেরিয়াল লাইফ ইজ আনস্টেবল আরে ফুলিশ ইউ ট্রাই টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ইউর সেলফ ফার্স্ট দ্য লাইফ ইজ আনস্টেবল দেন ওয়াই ইউ আর রানিং ইউ নো হিরণ্যাক্ষ গন দেন হিরণ্যকশিপু দেন হি ওয়াজ এ লাইফ স্মল ব্রাদার হিরণ্যাক্ষ গন দেন হিরণ্যকশিপু গোয়িং টু এক্সপ্লেন দিস ওয়ে লাইফ ইজ আনস্টেবল ট্রাই টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড মাদার এভরিবডি ইজ ইউ নো আরে ইউ ট্রাই টু ফুলিশ ইউ ট্রাই টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ফার্স্ট অফ অল ইউ ট্রাই টু আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড দিস পয়েন্ট ইউ ক্যান নট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাজ টু না মাই লাইফ ইজ আনস্টেবল ফুলিশ দেন রায়মাস আই ফাইনালি গোয়িং টু কোট দিস শ্লোক আই অলরেডি টোল্ড ইউ স্টার্ডে আজ্ঞা ঐব গুণান দোষান মায়াদিষ্টান উপি শকানো ধর্মান সন্ত্যাজ্য ইহ সর্বাণ মাম ভজেত স চ সত্যম আই ওয়াজ আই ক্যান নট টাচ দিস পয়েন্ট বিকজ আই অলরেডি ডিসকাস ইউ হ্যাভ টু রিমেম্বার হ্যাঁ নো ভগবান স্পিকিং ইন দ্য ইন ডিফারেন্ট শাস্ত্র আই মিন রাইটিং ইন ডিফারেন্ট ওয়েজ because there is different kind of quality of people they have no you know different kind of grade and quality I was bound to speak different way but anyway when you are going to satisfy me you have to think this way agya yoibam gunanam any kind different kind of instruction I have given but we just you have to follow because I was bound to speak for tamaguni rajaguni shataguni and for you are going to step into shuddha satoguna pure satoguni so for different kind of you know procedure you know must be there so that they can choose one right procedure at least they can go something somehow otherwise they cannot do anything they cannot do because they have no power so agya yoivam gunano dosano mayadishtano vidho I have given instruction according to the time and circumstances you will have to find merit and demerit all this thing and after that if you are going to dharmano santajyo you have to throw that all general dharmano santajyo yo sarvano mam bhajet anyhow he is going to fix up his target to satisfy me dharmano santajyo yo sarvano all different kind of as you are going to throw only mam bhajeto sa cha sattama he is actually sattama positive comparative superlative so mahat byakti I already told you that you are going to chatur vida vajante mang jana sukritin arjuno arto jigyaso artharth gyani cha bharatar sab they are actually trying vajante chatur vida vajante they are trying to do my bhajan so within that category kormi yogi bhakta all mix so out of them we are to categorize bhakta three type of I already told I am not going to repeat because time cannot permit sat bhakta shattaro positive comparative and superlative sattama bhakta bhagwan wanted to show a sattama bhakta he is going to ignore everything and going to take his target is to satisfy me is sattamo sattamo also sattamo this category also can be divided into three parts three category sattamo those sadhus those mahat they are in sattamo category but that category sattamo also should be divided into three parts three different categories also again divided avara sattama madhyam sattama apara sattama jiva goswami path going to show aduna different kind of sattvamo. One is avaro sattvamo. Avaro sattvamo, what is one? Madhyam sattvamo, aparam sattvamo. Raya Ramananta, actually, yesterday already discussed, you know, all 27 different kind of, you know, sattvamo bhakti, bhakta situated in sattvamo bhakti, then 27 different kind of symptoms, you know, I already discussed. Kono bhutke uddesh karena is not going to give, you know, pain to anybody, non-violence, friendship, merciful. I already explained, I cannot explain now. No. You know, not going to give to anybody anxiety, nothing. Matsarata, no man, jealousy, all you have to hear yesterday's harikatha. Now Raimasai going to speak from Swadharma tag, finally going to final satisfaction of Swadharma is Raimasai giving the example, Sarva Dharmanam Pateja Mamekun Sarano, this is the final. Samasto, any kind of Veda Dharma, Arjya Dharma, Niti Principal Dharma, Kula Dharma, Hereditical Dharma, you know, Loka Dharmas, Social Dharma, Varna Dharma, all. Who is going to take shelter unto my lotus feet exclusively? You know, that is Bhagavan saying, Ananya Bhavi, you will have to take shelter unto my lotus feet, Ananya Bhavi. There should not be any separate feeling, smell of any separate feeling. And in that case, if at all there is any adharma, sinful activities, I am responsible. I already explained, you can remember. Bikarmo jachot patitam kathanchit dhunoti sarvam hidisannivishto. I already explained, you forget. Many things I had discussed already. So, this way actually, when you are going to take shelter of Supreme Lord, if they are at all going to, you are going to make some adharma, bapap, sinful, but Krishna speaking, you need not think. It is my responsibility. Because this charan, this absolute saranagati, this is the final advice of Gita, and that is the starting point of Bhagavad Dharma. Now you try to understand your respective situation. When Gita is going to finish, that is the starting point without which we cannot start Bhagavad Dharma. What to speak about Raganuga Dharma and Rupanuga Dharma? Even we cannot start. Where Gita is going to finish, advice Saranapati Charam, absolute Saranagati, then from there Bhagavad Dharma is starting. So you will have to think twice. You can put me in this category of Bhagavad Dharma or not, that you will have to think twice. I think I am not, you know, I feel sorry. Anyway, if this kind of intellect actually, this kind of brain coming, pita, friend, you know, father, mother, children, everything, all my friends actually, you know, if somebody is going to think, how I can do bhajan, if I am going to leave my wife, husband, you know, children, it's possible. As then there was this, I have to do my own duty, no? As a mother and father or the son. Eh? But Krishna speaking, no, you need not play your head. Anyway, you are not going to touch any sinful activities. You are not going to do, at all you are going to do, you are not going to get result. It's mine. Then Prabhu speaking, Eho Vajyo Age Kahoar. We are so idiot that now I am going to give you an example. If a crow going to decorate body, you know, like peacock. You know, a crow like to decorate full body like peacock. How long that crow can make drama? How long he can run with its drama? can break down. So, it is impossible. Who is Raghunu Gopal? Raghunu Gopal, not a matter of lecture. It is not a matter of lecture. Your symptom, your quality, your behavior, your character, your, you know, procedure of bhajan, all your etiquette, everything can prove. Simply because there is no experienced devotees. Those who are versed in bhajan, that's why everybody like to make fool of you. You have no experience. If you have experience, you have fear, then how people can make fool of you? So, there is no... So, everybody like to follow a blind man. Okay, the wrong way. Wrong way they are running. Okay, they are running wrong way. They are speaking, we are doing bhajan also. Okay, you do bhajan. Experienced sadhu, those are totally established in, you know, Bhagavad Dharma, totally. They can realize, when they can look at you, they can look at your eyes, they can understand. Simply for a very short period, they can watch your character, speech, everything, they can conclude. I can give one example. I am not making any story. One day, Prabhupada was in Govardhan, making Govardhan Parikram. That time he was, you know, he was there in the way of his Govardhan Parikrama, Prabhupada and his group and his followers. They're going to Govindakund. I don't like to speak the name of that sadhu. He's very famous sadhu. Very, very famous sadhu. But not from Gaudiya Math. Then Prabhupada meet that sadhu at the bank of Govindakund. And he is asking some question to Prabhupada. Prabhupada also wanted to discuss something about bhajan. Then after discussion is over, Prabhupada speaking, this sadhu is very nice sadhu. Prabhupada speaking, his procedure of bhajan is okay. Now, who is there? Who can arrest me? Hey, you are doing wrong bhajan. Who can speak? Who can slap me? Prabhupada is not there. Keshav Goswami is not. Whatever I like, I can do. I am mad. I am crazy. This is the bhajan procedure at present. Then Prabhupada actually speaking, his bhajan procedure is okay. He is not doing wrong bhajan. Then some devotee asking, Prabhupada, we heard that he is Siddha Mahatma. Is it so? All devotees, after coming back from in Govindakund doing parikram, and in the way some sadhus asking to followers, some of his followers, Prabhupada, asking to Prabhupada, Prabhupada, some of those people, they're saying Siddha Mahatma, Siddha Sadhu, is it so? Prabhupada, no. His bhajan procedure is okay. He is, if this way he can continue his bhajan, today or tomorrow, surely he can meet with success, Siddha Mahatma. But at present he is not Siddha. Because Prabhupada can see. Because Prabhupada can see very clearly, so clearly Prabhupada can see. If we become, feel sorry, oh, Prabhupada speaking this way, what use? We are here to do bhajan of that absolute truth. But we are less interested to take shelter of even general truths. What is the fallacy? What is the fun? It is a laughing stroke. It is really a laughing stroke. That we are coming here to do bhajan of that absolute truth. Whereas, who among us ready to accept that apparent truth? That is the question. It is a one kind of laughing stroke. I am Acharya, I am big Acharya, this. Hare Maharaj, you have to prove it. You have to prove, not that in a false philosophy is not, you know. So this way we find all wrong conception prevailing all over the world. Nobody like to follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Nobody like to follow, you know, perfectly. And they are following something, not follow. So this way you see, when somebody going to speak that I can incur some bad result, sinful if I live, no. Then no. So, eho vajjo, it is external, you will have to go further. If I can become a joker, and speak like this. It is external. Dubo Maharaj Bhalla, he said nothing. Useless, you can go up. I am Raganuga Bhakta, Rupanuga Bhakta. So useless. Prahlad useless. Yes, external, you go. Maharaj, you are going to jump into fire. Be sure. Don't be angry with me. I am speaking about the absolute truth. Those who are going to follow this kind of, you know, duplicate procedure, only going to, you know, follow this kind of duplicate procedure, they can speak. It is external. You can go up. Even their Saksha Bhakti, Vatsala, it is external. Throw. That's useless. You can go up. They actually crow. They are actually crow. They are not peacock. They like to exhibit themselves as peacock, but they actually crow. In infinity life, I think they cannot come out because they have done aparad. Antolotus Field Bhakti Mitchell Prabhupada, Guru Bharga Raganuga Bhakta Rupa Goswami. They are not following them properly and misguiding the whole world. So they are crow. They are not, they like to climb the head because peacock, one feather of peacock going to climb the head of crown of Krishna. So if I am crow, I want to try again, okay, I am crow, so what? So I can get the, I can climb the, you know, head of Krishna. Impossible. Impossible. Duplicity not allowed in the way of bhajan. In that case, when he is going to leave everything, you know, everything, that sadhu sattama, I already explained, and sattama also, you know, I can discuss avaro sattama, madhyam sattama, and param sattama. I mean, avaro mane, primary sattama, mediocre sattama, and absolute sattama. I can discuss this point. So now, first of all, what Rai Ramananda is speaking, and, you know, Rai Ramananda is speaking this way, and after that, you know, we can get evidence. Anyway, he is not going to get any bad result. For years, he is going to live on Varnasana Dharma. But there should not be any duplicity. When Mahaprabhu wanted to know more detail about it, Then actually, Mahaprabhu, actually Rai Ramananda speaking, Gyanamishra Bhakti Shaddosar. Gyanamishra Bhakti. Gyan is the predominating factor. Gyan is the predominating factor. What is this Gyan? If I go on discussing, it will take long time. Gyan. You know, different categories of Gyan there. Gyan Mishra Bhakti, Gyan Sun, and I know, follow. Atapa Rai Ramananda speaking, Gyan Mishra Bhakti Sadhana. Here Bhakti is there, Kintu Suddha Bhakti is not there. Gyan Mishra, contaminated with Gyan. And this Bhakti is separate from those Mayavadi, those who proclaim that we are Gyani. Here I am not speaking about him. Also, I can discuss this point in clear way so that everybody can. Gyan mean they can also think they are also Gyani. But Gyanamishra Bhakti mean Bhakti is already there. But those Mayavadi, anyway, they are not going to get any smell of Bhakti. Because they think, if we are going to accept another Tattva, Maya, Bhakti, then Advaigan Tattva, we cannot stand. We cannot stand with our argument. We can get failure. So better we can throw everything. No, nothing is there, only Adhyayagyanta. Hey, Maharaj, you know, Adhyayagyanta, they think nothing there, even Maya, nothing, no, nothing there. They never going to confess, Gyan Mishra Bhakti. But, previously I told you Karma Mishra Bhakti, now Gyan Mishra Bhakti, Rai Ramananda Singh, Gyan Mishra Bhakti, Lakshan, what is the definition of, you know, Gyan Mishra Bhakti? Then Rai Mahasaya is going to quote the slok from Gita. What is that? Brahma bhuta prasanyatma na sachati na kankati samaha sarveshu bhuteshu madbhaktim labhate param. Brahma bhuta atat Nirvishesh impersonal Brahma Anubhav is little there. The Brahma is all pervading, infinity world. You know. And Brahmanda, and they have no feeling. They have no feeling of this material, they have no material feeling. Brahma Bhuto Prasanyatma. You know, Brahmanda Madhavati, there is a material feeling not there. Brahma, both Sunno. Feeling is not there. Prasanyatma, they are satisfied. Why? They have no demand. Why they are satisfied? They have no demand. Abhava dharma rohit. No question of any demand is there, that's why. Atat jaravastur abhave shok rohit. If there is nothing there in his life, still he is very satisfied. Because he is not expecting any material thing. He is always going to think about Bhuma Purush. Bhuma, money, infinity world. All pervading supreme. Oh, great, omnipresent. You know, Bhuma. Sarvada. Ajo, you know, is never going to take birth. This kind of bhavana. And they have no, you know, no feeling of, you know, pain. No duksha. Tao, hundreds of different kind of painful situation can come in their life. Still, Brahma-bhūtaha prasanyātmā na sachati na kankati. They are not having any anxiety, nothing, na sachati. You know, they are not going to think anything, na kankati, no expectation, samaha sarveshu bhuteshu. They are having equal vision. Samaha sarveshu bhuteshu. Because they think everywhere that Brahma was too present. Samaha sarva bhuteshu madbhaktim labate param. He can ultimately can get bhakti if suitable situation is created in their life, then automatically they can get bhakti. Otherwise, if they are going to step into mayavad, it's different. But this procedure is not mayavad totally, you know. Those who are going to ignore Sri Nam, Rup, Gun, Lila, Sandhan, Rahit, Bhuma, Parichinno, Bhavna, you know, they are actually think this is this material thing going to put them in, going to put them in pain. No, it is atat bastu, it is useless. It is not that. It neti. It is not that. You have to think. And that Gyani, it is basically I am explaining. But that Gyani doesn't mean that he will have to become a Nirvisheshvadi impersonal, not that. Gyani, Bhakta, the Gyani, these those who are Gyani, you know. Gyan Mishra Bhakti, I can explain. So Gyani, two types of Gyani. One is those who are impersonalist. That kind of knowledge, Gyan, we like to throw out and Savishesh for Gyan. Those are having, mixing up Bhakti, they feel if Supreme Lord is there. Anyway, they are thinking about Brahma, but still, they also believe in the eternal future of Supreme Lord. They are Gyani, because totally they are not going to take shelter of Bhakti, Gyana Mishra Bhakti. Savishesh for Gyani Bhakti Sange Bhagavan. Those who are that type of Gyani, those who are going to get right association of Bhakta, then when they are hearing, then Sachidanandata Sikar Karen. They are bound to believe Sachidananda Rupatta, you know, of Supreme Lord. Chatusan, you know, Navajogendra, Sukhdev Goswami. They are this type of Savishes Gyani. They are Gyani. Sukhdev Goswami also, you remember, I told already. Parinishchito opinairgunne grihito guna lelaya. I was thinking about impersonal, but ultimately I was attracted by Savishes, by the beauty, excellency of Supreme Lord. So, Navajangando is a master, they are master, they are preaching Harikatha, Chatusan also, because they are Gyani, Savishes Gyani. They are not impersonalist. You know, Chatusan we know, when going to get the smell of Tulasi Chandan, which was already offered unto the lotus feet of Narayan, they got the smell of, they changed their mood. Aksharojusamu pinoirgunne. Aksharojusamati. Previously, Om iti ekaksharam, this, you know, Brahma Vastu, they used to worship. But now, they're changing their mind. They are attracted by the smell of the chandan and tulsi flower offered, already offered unto Lord Narayan. But we are not speaking about Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasipu, Ravana, Birochan. We are not speaking about that. Jarasandha, they all impersonalist. They are doing all, or they are doing arsiv, jagya, everything, but they don't believe Vishnu. Vishnu coming, Krishna coming in front of jagya. Oh, who is coming? Oh, you are actually begging something. I must keep, because atithi belayam. In the noontime, if somebody coming in grihastha room, they must give prasadam, water, everything should be there. Arrangement should be there. Because atithi, a guest is like Narayan. You know, in our Vedic culture, we treat any atithi, guest is like Narayan. Narayan. You know, so Nirvishesh Brahma, those are impersonalists. They are a Gyani. They are also Gyani. Ravana is also Gyani. But we are not going to give any value to their Gyan. Nirvishesh Gyani, Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakasipu, Ravana, Virachan, Jarasandha, they all. They are not going to believe Krishna or Vishnu, but they are doing everything. Nirvishesh Brahma. When Krishna coming, you are kayak, you are coward. I don't like to fight with you. It is derogatory for me. You are coward. Useless. This is, you know, he also cannot fight. His body structure is not suitable, so that I am a stout figure. So with Arjuna also I cannot fight. I can find a Bhima, Tulla Bala. He is like me. I can fight with. I can choose Bhima. Well, Bhima can go, Gada Yuddha. He is going to give one club to Bhima and take another club himself. I am going in the field for fighting for long time without any solution, fighting going on. Who can kill Jarasandha? Impossible. Bhimsena was also fed up. Ultimately, Bhagavan was bound to give some indication, this way you cannot defeat Jarasandha anyhow. You have to follow this procedure. What is the procedure? You have to tear up from the middle of the body. Krishna taking one straw and, you know, making a bifurcate, cut into two, you know, tear it up into two pieces and throw just, you know, one is right hand side in the left, right hand side, right hand straw, going to throw left hand side, and left hand straw, going to throw right hand side. Wanted to mean that you can tear up the whole body of Jarasandha and throw just opposite, not that in line. Then again that cut, you know, half body can, you know, can get unified. This kind of benediction there. So you will have to tear up from in between and throw just opposite. So you see, they are also Nirvishesh Gyani. We are less interested about them. We are not going to think about them. So, Gyan Mishra Bhakti, what type of Bhakti I can show? This is not at all Bhakti. They are going to show that we have Bhakti but Nirvishesh, you know, we are Nirvishesh, but Nirvishesh, but they are Aparadhi. Mahaprabhu is saying they are Aparadhi, they are great offender. Because they are going to ignore the eternal Sarupa of Supreme Lord. Anyway, who is going to care what kind of Gyan is there? So, Nirvishesh Kalpana, In the when Sukadeva Goswami is going to think Nirvishesh Brahma, but still inside this, in the form of seed, there was Savishesh Brahma. Nirvishesh Kalpunar Madhe, Sachidananda Bhagavan Dibba Murti, Vishesh Samuho Supto Thaki. Try to understand. I can give one example, I can stop today. Like Bharat Maharaj going to chant everything, everything he is doing. When he is going to do japa and tarpan, you know, in water of Gandaki Nadi, when sun god going to rise, in the light of sun god, he used to meditate the Supreme Lord. It is also Gyan Mishra Bhakti. That's why I told long ago that Bharat Maharaj's bhajan was Gyan Mishra Bhakti. You know, he is not going to show immediately, going to serve that way, but having some impersonal Brahma. But their Savishesh Bhava is seed, in the form of seed there. This way, I can discuss that the two groups, and I can also discuss about Sattama Bhakta divided into three groups. Again, three groups already. I already told Avara Sattama, Madhyam Sattama, and Param Sattama. I can discuss this tomorrow to give you some clear idea about this. Kaena vacha manasa indriyairva buddhvatmana va anusrito svabhava karoti yad yad sakalam parasmai narayaneti samarpayetvat vacha kalpadarvasi ke basindi bhavacha pachitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo.